fruit for great fruit taste, so you can move to a different beat.
Oh, wow!
5 days a week, starting September 19th on Fox 5.
Hey, did you hear?
Did you hear?
Did you hear?
Did you hear?
Did you hear? Did you hear that Bob's grand opening sale is going on now at all Bob's stores?
You'll save on Bob's store's entire stock of men's, ladies, and kids' Levi's jeans.
Will we duck for sale?
Don't you mean dockers are on sale at Bob's?
Oh, boy. 20% off health techs and Oshkosh for kids.
Hey, where are you going? Reeboks. Just $30 at Bob's.
Flash, celebrate the grand opening of Bob's two New Jersey stores with this huge sale going on now at all Bob's stores' locations.
Most people think of an alcoholic as somebody who's hanging outside the Queens Midtown Tunnel wiping windshields. And that's not the truth. The truth of the matter is, the alcoholic is your garbage collector, it's your cop on the beat, it's your doctor, it's your TV cameraman, it's the bus driver, it's everyone. Alcoholism is everywhere, and alcoholism affects everyone. Do something about it. Call Seafield today. We can help.
Giants! Big Blue is going to rock you all season long on Fox 5.
I got to thank you guys right off the top for watching this week. We have an incredible report lined up being brought to you by Domino's Pizza. That's right, this year, Domino's delivers SummerSlam. It's got to be Domino's. And I got to be Todd Pettengill. No one else wanted to be. Certainly the macho man doesn't want to be me. Did you see those girls with Randy at the pool? Tough life, huh? Anyway, folks, 2 weeks from this Monday night, August the 29th, 8 o'clock Eastern, 5 Pacific, from the brand new United Center in Chicago, and totally live on pay-per-view cable television, SummerSlam 1994. Just look at this place. Now, think what it's going to look like, filled with 23,000 superfans. Whew, it's going to be awesome. All right, let's jump into it and talk about the first half of that awesome double main event. The Undertaker versus The Undertaker. This is just amazing. We've got two Undertakers and two Leslie Nielsens, according to that last report. We also have two brothers battling for the WWF Championship. That's the second half of the humongous double main event. Champion Bret Hart against the challenger Owen Hart inside that 15-foot steel cage. The Hart family sharply divided, tempers flaring, words flying. We saw the King of Hearts earlier on, and he certainly looks ready, but so does the champion.
So, you know, it's a pretty solemn occasion around the old Hart house nowadays, knowing that two brothers are going to go into a 15-foot-high steel cage match, and there's no way back forever. Owen, I hope you're happy, because this is the final match. This is the match to end all matches. It's going to be over. You know, I've had my sister Georgia come up and go, please, please, don't do it. Don't fight Owen. Don't fight Owen. Well, I gotta fight Owen. I've had my brother Ross come up. Everybody in my family wants this thing to be stopped. And there's only one way to stop it. And that's by being there in the SummerSlam. My whole family is gonna be there. And they're gonna watch me beat you, Owen, fair and square. And when I do that, and it's not gonna be a pretty sight, Owen. And I know you're going to have a hard time swallowing it. And that big fat tub, Jim Neidhart, he's going to have a hard time swallowing it. But we both know that everybody in my family, everybody is going to be backing me up. And they know the only way to end this thing is by destroying you once and for all in the SummerSlam. Owen, everything's at stake. Brother, you're going down.
Man, I guess there's not much chance of a Hart family Labor Day picnic this year. Incredible. All right, folks, onward here. As you know, the Intercontinental title also on the line as the 7-foot monster Diesel takes on the bad guy Razor Ramon. Shawn Michaels in Big Daddy Cool's corner, and I cannot wait to see Sweetness Walter Payton backing up the bad guy. SummerSlam 94 will also feature a battle of former friends. Lex Luger will square off against Tatanka. Now, earlier on, you saw what transpired on Monday Night Raw last week. We sent our camera crews to get an update with these two WWF superstars.
You know, Tatanka, you've done something that a friend never does to a friend. I come down to the ring to lend you a helping hand, and what do? Jump to conclusions again. I go to straighten things out afterwards with Ted DiBiase once and for all, and you jump in and you jump to conclusions once again. Well, let me tell you something, Tatanka. You have questioned everything I stand for. Everything I believe in, every inner fiber of my being. And Tatanka, You asked for it. Now you got a match with me. I'm going to show that I didn't sell out, and I'm going to beat you in SummerSlam.
So, Lex Luger, you're trying to show the people that you came down to try to save me on Monday Night Raw. Who are you kidding? You tried to come down to take me out because I've exposed you. I go looking for you. What do I find you? I find you in the million-dollar man's dressing room, you turncoat. Lex Luger, you have sold out, and at SummerSlam, finally, the whole world will see what Lex Luger is all about.
Boy, can you imagine those two powerhouses colliding? We will all see it at SummerSlam. Should be quite a matchup. Folks, tag title on the line at SummerSlam as well, when the Head Shrinkers take on the Million Dollar Man team of IRS and Bam Bam Bigelow. Plus, the WWF Women's title up for grabs as Alundra Blaze takes on the awesome Bull Nakano, managed by Luna Vachon. And folks, Bull and Luna, no pun intended, are full of it.
Alundra Blaze, it's my pleasure to let you know what Bull Nakano's gonna do to you. But best of all, she's gonna take your title. All right.
Folks, what an awesome night of action this is going to be. 2 weeks from this Monday night, the 29th of August, 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific, from the brand new United Center in Chicago and exclusively on pay-per-view cable television. All right, you got 2 minutes to grab a sandwich and then get on back here. Because after that, we're going to take the garbage out. Duke the Dumpster Drossy coming up next.
For a great new taste.
Welcome to Burger King.
Hi, what's this new Bacon Maker Supreme?
It's delicious. A third pound of flame broiled beef.
And I really need to have one.
With crispy bacon.
I love bacon.
Melted cheese, lettuce, and tomato.
I'm starving. This is torture.
I have one.
Yes, sir.
But would you mind eating it where I don't have to watch?
The new flame broiled Bacon Maker Supreme. More great taste for more great value at Burger King.
Is it break time yet?
Come now!
Oh, yeah!
What's big?
He's no black and white world. So live in full color.
Yeah, man.
No reason to hide, to come out from under.
What's big?
Justified to be brave. No reason to fear.
No reason to fear.
Express your big self as long as you're here.
Oh, yeah.
And let no man make you his guinea pig. And no man will that you just stay big.
You must stay big. Big.
I couldn't believe it.
Starting when I was about 22, 23. I was practically bald.
Men's Hair Now can make you look like you used to.
They've got this Dermabond process.
It's completely undetectable.
My girlfriend doesn't even know about it.
It's so easy, you don't even have to think about
it. I'm more confident now than I've ever been.
Now you can have a full head of hair again with Men's Hair Now. Men and women, if you're losing your hair, call 1-800-HAIR-202 for a free consultation. 1-800-HAIR-202.
This is Medieval Times, Dinner and Tournament, the show of legend. It's hour after hour of feasting and festivity, from the spectacle of sport to the thrill of the joust. Medieval Times in Lyndhurst, New Jersey, near the Meadowlands. Ask about our $39.95 couple special. Some restrictions apply.
Doctor, we're running out of time.
I'm moving as fast as humanly possible. A cranial postular discectomy is a very dangerous procedure. Scissors.
Hurry, please. You've got to.
Scalpel. Oh, no. We're not going to make it.
Doctor, it's time.
Welcome, everyone, to Monday Night Raw. Vince McMahon here along with a bunch of
the new WWF generation. It'll make your heart beat faster.
Okay, now where were we?
Welcome back, everybody. Thanks for staying with us. Jim Ross and the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase with you. Hope you're enjoying this exciting week of WWF action. And here comes the trash man here in the WWF, Duke the Dumpster Drossy.
That's the best call you've had all day, Jim Ross. Can you smell
smell that. This is disgusting.
Well, I'll tell you something that's not disgusting is the fact that our pal Leslie Nielsen will indeed be at SummerSlam, and I can't wait to see him there. Speaking of SummerSlam, the WWF Sunday Slam special will be next Sunday night. There's a little gift there for the youngster.
I wouldn't wear that thing. It probably stinks.
I'm sure that young person will treasure that memento from this young WWF superstar.
Hey, well, the only thing worse than watching this is watching you dance.
Well, I'm working on some new dance steps. Maybe I'll introduce those in the next few months. One thing that I am going to do is I'm going to pick up my telephone and vote on the WWF SummerSlam hotline, because the fans are given the opportunity to vote. Is Lex Luger associated now with the Million Dollar Man, or is he not? And we're interested in finding out what the wrestling fans think of that.
Oh, you are. Well, I really don't care what you think, and I don't care what they think. The bottom line is, he's with the corporation. What a bunch of doubting Thomases.
Well, he hasn't said that.
Have I ever lied to you before?
Let's not get into that. We're almost out of time this week. It's going to be Duke the Dumpster Drosy and George Anderson.
You're really pushing it, Ross.
Oh, Fire McCary takeover by Duke the Dumpster Drosy. He's learning some more wrestling maneuvers each and every week here in the WWF.
Yeah, he learned that from rolling garbage cans over his back.
Big, impressive individual. By the way, ladies and gentlemen, the current WWF magazine, the one with the King of Hearts and his insane brother-in-law, the Anvil, on the cover, is on sale now at newsstands nationwide. Nice offense there by George Anderson. And on the inside, special article entitled, The King Takes Out the Garbage. Hip lock takeover by Duke the Dumpster Drosy.
I wish somebody would take out this garbage. Oh, that was an intelligent statement.
Well, he got right to the point. It's time to take out the trash. Boy, that almost like a corkscrew elbow there. Very, very effective. As Duke the Dumpster Drosy overpowered his opponent once again here this week. Can't say a lot for his ring attire, but...
Well, if he wants to take out the trash, he needs to head for the door.
And in the trash can!
Well, Duke the Dumpster Drosy once again victorious here this week. Wait a minute. George Anderson came off the apron. He's got some fight left in him. He's got some fight left in him, and he caught Duke from behind. Got that big plastic trash can there. I guess he's going to trash compact old George. Ringing his bell there, George.
Now, that's disgusting.
Well, it is rather disgusting, but...
That is just disgusting.
George should have tried to sneak attack there.
Wham, bam, and in the trash can, just like I said.
All right. Duke the Dumpster Drosy, as we said, victorious, as we prepare to take you to the Live Event News.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
I always like to keep my favorite snack handy. The old excitement, step into a Slim Jim. Oh, yeah!
Welcome back, Big Apple. The W.